Many of 3.js's geometry objects come along with their own UVs built in. Some of these are displayed here. For planar objects, the texture is put flat against the face. For round objects, the general idea is that the U value goes from 0 to 1 around the equator, and V goes from 0 to 1 along the axis. To be honest, the mapping on the bottom of the cone shown here is pretty, but doesn't make a lot of sense to me. Maybe you'll be the one to fix it. Note that 3.js truly is a work in progress, and anyone can submit bug fixes and improvements. I should also point out the tetrahedron. Its mapping is a bit distorted. In fact, if you look at the code, no UV mapping is given at all, and 3.js creates one using some rules. Sometimes there simply is no natural UV mapping for the object being made. It's then pretty much up to the programmer to decide how to proceed. What is happening with each of these objects is that the UVs are generated by the geometry class used to create the triangles. The form for making a triangle with UVs is this code. Here, three vertices are defined and put inside the geometry object. Three UVs are created. I put them in an array so I can reuse any that I want. A face is defined as usual. The three numbers given are indices to the three vertex locations in the vertices array. The way the three UVs are attached to this face is a little non-standard. The first element of the face vertex UVs is accessed, and the three UVs we want to use for this face are directly placed there. If you want to add more faces with UVs, note that you'll access the face vertex UVs class the same way each time. You'll access array element 0 and pass in the three UVs desired.